topic which I have never actually spoken about in public before. On the 12th of December 2010, I was arrested and my home was raided. My face was put in the media as a wanted person. Now, I'm aware that not everybody in this room will even know who I am, but could you please do me a favor? And if you saw my face on December 12th, 2010, as a wanted person, can you raise your hand, please? Okay. Now, the reason why I did that, I'm glad it wasn't that many people. It's not the most, not my most proud moment in the world. But the fact is this: why did this happen, and what was going on, and what am I currently facing in my life and in my career as a whole? What Johnny was speaking about before, when he was talking about people being in court yesterday, I was in court yesterday. I had things taken from my house, which I have still not been given back. Anything in my room that had Arabic writing on it was taken. I have, today there's some t-shirts of mine, the Lowkey, Keep It Lowkey, Abomination ones. They took those from my house. They took lyrics from my house. They took clothes from my house. They took anything remotely political from my house. Why? Why? Well, something the prosecutor said to my lawyer yesterday at the courthouse, he said, you're defending that rapper that was detained in Israel, right? What Johnny is talking about in terms of these political arrests, these political charges and these political trials is completely on point. When you decide to say things which go away from the elite narrative, from the narrative of how the powers that be want you to perceive the world, then you are in danger. You are in danger in one way or another. Now, a perfect example of that is when Mike Righteous said the words Free Palestine on BBC One Extra. Now, the words were edited out, the freestyle. Now, I've spoken to the DJ about this, and he told me the decision went all the way to Mark Thompson. Who is Mark Thompson? What is the BBC? What is its function? The BBC is state-run television. It is run by the British state. It is funded by us, the taxpayer, but it is run by the British state. In the same way, Press TV is run by the Iranian state. In the same way, RT, Russia Today, is run by the Russian government. The British Broadcasting Corporation is run by our government. Is run by our government. Who is Mark Thompson? And what did he mean by this decision went all the way up to Mark Thompson? Mark Thompson is the Director General of the BBC. In fact, the highest paid man employee of the BBC. He makes almost £1 million per year of public money. The Director General. This Director General in 2006 went and met with Ariel Sharon, the butcher of Sabra and Shapira, who even the Israelis have said was guilty, but was still allowed to go and take higher positions in the Israeli government. Now, what is the Director General of the BBC doing meeting with an incredibly powerful Israeli politician? What do you think they sit there and talk about? You think they sit there and talk about profits? Do you think they sit there and talk about shooting demonstrations? What do you actually think these people sit and talk about? They talk about the way in which the BBC can serve Israeli interests. Why would Ariel Sharon meet with this man? That's what he does. He works for Israeli interests. Israeli interests are the expansion of a state in the Middle East. So why should we be surprised when this man, Mark Thompson, is taking it upon himself to censor rappers' lyrics on the radio? And why? Why is it more controversial? Literally the next rap after Free Palestine was still up on the fed. Yeah? I love it. Why? Is it more controversial for a person to say Free Palestine than I benefit? Are you telling me that is the state of play that we are in today? That for the BBC it's more controversial for them to err a person saying Free Palestine than them to say I will harm a police officer? Is this the status quo? Is this the situation? I will harm the people who are meant to protect the British state. Free Palestine, which one do you want to edit? Which one do you think should be edited? As a fair-minded human being? Or as a person that is protecting the interests of your state, that is putting forth this narrative? Why is it that Milbank was less protected than the Israeli embassy back in 2008 and 2009? What? How is that possible? A foreign embassy in London is better protected than the headquarters of the party in government. This is crazy. So, the situation with me was I was arrested for violent disorder, which carries a maximum of 5 years in prison. I was placed on bail. Now my bail condition, and this is why you've heard very little music from me. I've been not very active these past 6 months, because this is what I've been dealing with. My bail conditions were that I was not allowed to enter the borough of Westminster with absolutely no charge. I was told that if I entered the borough of Westminster, I would be arrested. This is from December 12, 2010. No charge. Then, on April 26, 2011, I was eventually charged and presented with evidence, supposed evidence, with a fray, which is less than violent disorder. Alfie Meadows was charged with violent disorder. A fray carries a maximum of 3 years in prison. My trial, I'm not sure when it's going to be, but I'm back to court on July the 19th, and then they will give me a date for the Crown Court. Now, what we have to think about, and what we have to understand, is how the hypocrisy of a government that when the revolution was taking place in Egypt, you had men on horseback charging into people. I was there, and men on horseback were charging into us in this country. And you know what else? You know those people, you know the security people in Egypt, you know who they were armed by? They were armed by BAE systems, which is like this with our government. Like the hand to the glove is BAE systems and our government.
I've seen the weapons there.
Now the elite narrative that we are meant to take and believe and pledge allegiance to and say, this is how I see the world, this is my worldview. The elite narrative tells us that this is a completely natural relationship. That it is natural for our government to arm dictatorships all over the world that suppress their people and that murder them. On the 26th of April, I was charged with a fray, and I was not only banned from the borough of Westminster, but because the royal wedding was taking place, I was banned from the City of London until May the 2nd. As of May the 2nd, my bail conditions were dropped. And this is why in the first part of the year, I was able to travel. The fact that I could travel over 24 hours away to Australia with my DJ Awate, but I couldn't enter the borough of Westminster. I could go and tour in the United States, but I couldn't enter the borough of Westminster. 56 people were arrested on the day of the royal wedding. Some of them in these new quote-unquote pre-crime arrests. People were arrested because they were suspected that they would commit some type of quote-unquote disorder. Let's even talk about the context of the situation with me. Now, before anything of what I've been accused of happened, my DJ, Awate, my good friend, was punched in the face by the police. This is all on YouTube. You can see the footage on YouTube of me being punched in the face. It's got quite a few thousand hits. So.
Is that him?
One of my best friends in the world, Jody McIntyre, as has now been admitted by the police, was dragged from his wheelchair and struck with a baton. The police have admitted that that did happen. You probably all saw it on the news, and the footage is everywhere, of him being dragged from his wheelchair onto the floor. That happened. Another friend of mine was assaulted, and I too was assaulted. This is the context in which what happened, and what is being alleged to have happened, happened. So, it's important for us to understand that if a person like Alfie Meadows can be beaten so badly that he needs brain surgery to save his life and then be put on trial, they're trying to send that man to prison for 5 years. That's what they want to do. There are people who are being paid to work on sending a man who almost died to prison for 5 years. If that can happen to him, what makes you so different? What makes any of us so different? And exactly what logic says, it's about seeing all of us as part of the same body, part of the same human family, part of the same human family. But we look at people in Iraq born with all manner of deformities. We must look at them as if they are our children, because in one way or another they are. Did the bombs that were dropped in the area around them not say made in Britain? Did they not say made in the USA? And what do our passports say? Did they not say Britain? United Kingdom? There is nothing separating us from each other, and there is nothing which makes us superior or anybody else inferior. There is nothing that makes me special or you special. Nothing. We are all part of the same family, part of the same human body, and we must see each other. Was very important, I feel, and I would urge you all, not just, you know, this time next year, I might be in prison, and if I am, I don't want to be a face on a t-shirt. I want to be remembered, but I want what I believe in to be remembered. That's the most important thing, and I don't want you to turn around and say, you give me support. Of course, I am thankful for everyone and anyone that supports me through this situation, but I want you to support the entire movement and realize that ultimately what we are talking about is a group of men who received their university education for free. This was the generation that they came from. They received university education. To pay 9 grand per year. And there was a study that shows that 3/4 of the people that will pay this feast will die in debt. Will die in debt. Who do we stand with? Who do we stand with? And we can take this and apply this to any single situation in the world. Say, who do you stand with? Who is your solidarity with? Is your solidarity with the policeman that dragged Jody off his chair? Or is it with Jody? Even if that policeman was your brother, is your solidarity with your blood brother or with the man your blood brother dragged off a chair and hit with a baton? Where does your solidarity lie? Is it like with Alvin Meadows, who almost died and is now being subjected to a trial? Does it lie with him, or does it lie with the police? Does it lie with the politicians who got their education for free, or does it lie with the people who don't believe that is right? Does it lie with Theodore Herzl, Ariel Sharon, or does it lie with the indigenous people of Palestine? Does it lie with Captain Cook, or does it lie with the Aboriginal indigenous people of Australia? Does it lie with Christopher Columbus, or does it lie with the indigenous people of what we now call the United States? Where does your solidarity lie? That is the question.